What's up, everyone? Okay, so you want to start trading. You need to make sure that you have the right setup. Okay, so as you probably realized, you can't make a living trading from your iPhone, okay? So if you're serious about learning how to trade, you obviously need to set up a proper trading environment. And when it comes to setting up a trading environment, you know, you can get as complex and as expensive as you'd like, okay? So what I like to do is I like to try to keep it simple, but naturally my desk over time has grown, okay? So what I would suggest is starting with a solid core system, so to speak, and then you can expand as you please over time, okay? So today we're quickly going to review how I set up my system. I actually started really, really simple with one laptop, that's it. Then I added an external monitor, okay? And then gradually over time, I slowly added more monitors and as I needed more space, so to speak, and until it grew to the current 7 monitor setup, okay? And I'm sure it will grow more over time. So as you can see here is how I started. Well, technically, a couple of steps ahead of how I started. I started with what we have here, just a very simple laptop. That's it. Then sometime later, I added an external USB monitor, which is what you see here on the left, okay? It's a very simple monitor. It's really cool, really light, and you can just, you know, plug it into any USB port in your laptop. Then I got an external screen, okay, which is what you see here on the right, and this is a HDMI screen, which I connected to the HDMI port on the laptop. You could also connect this screen to the VGA port on the laptop if your laptop has one, okay? So that was that. Now, keep in mind that in addition to being a trader, I'm also running our training groups and a mastermind, okay? So this clearly requires a lot more monitors than, you know, just trading would require. So, and this is what I have now, okay? Which is a 7 monitor setup, okay? So let's start with the computer. I'm using a single HP desktop PC, okay? I believe that HP computers are some of the best, are some of the longest lasting machines when it comes to kind of heavyweight computer users, okay? I mean, hardcore meaning that, you know, this machine is on really most hours of the day, okay? So, yeah, you know, HPs are slightly more expensive than the average, but they're well worth it, okay? So, although mine wasn't originally built as such, I realized that most gaming type computers are well suited for trading because they A, have good amounts of memory, and B, they have you know, quite advanced graphics cards, which you need when you run, if you're running a lot of monitors, okay? As a personal preference, I prefer desktop computers to laptops, because they tend to be a lot easier to upgrade memory and component-wise over time, and also they tend to cost a fair bit less than an equivalent specification in a laptop format, okay? I had more than one computer when I was trading for the investment banks, so I would have, you know, different screens linked to different computers. I don't have that anymore. I kind of find it very messy when it comes to moving data from one machine to the other, copy-pasting and everything. I just don't like it. I find it messy. Now, the monitors. Okay, as you can see, I'm using a variety of monitors. In my old setup, as you may remember, I had the main laptop, then I had a 15-inch USB portable monitor, which is the one that you see here on the left. And then I had a 21-inch traditional monitor, which is, I think, the one you see here in the center, okay? Now, I really, really like the portable USB monitor because it kind of really slides into my Wenger laptop bag easily, and I can take it with me anywhere I want, anywhere I go traveling, so I can have, you know, 2 monitors on the go, no problems. Now, as far as the video cards and the adapters go, I always get people asking me, you know, how can I run so many monitors on a single machine? It's quite simple, actually. So the PC has 2 video cards. It has the native video card, which is the one that, you know, the original computer came with. And then it's got an extra video card, okay? The native video card supports 1 screen. And then I added a second video card. It wasn't expensive. I think it was like a couple of hundred bucks or so, and that supports an extra two screens, okay? But here's the twist. I then got an external video display splitter that effectively turns one single screen into three screens, okay? Pretty cool, huh? So we have one screen connected to the native video card. Then we have the additional video card that has two screen outputs. One screen output goes to one screen, and then the second screen output on the second video card is split into three screens, okay? So now we've gone from one screen on the original computer to a total of four screens, okay? We've got one screen on the native video card, then the new video card has two outputs. The first output goes to one screen, and then the second output goes to three screens. Actually, that's a total of five. It's late in the day, can't even count anymore. Okay, cool. Then we have the portable monitor. Okay, that's the 15-inch mini monitor here on the left. And that just can be connected into any port, you know, just plug and play, which is really cool. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now the seventh one, here's the trick, okay? I got a USB video card that effectively transforms any USB port into a video card. So essentially you can plug in any monitor to that. So I got one of those, and that's how I got the seventh screen. It's literally through this video card, it's connected to a USB port, which is really cool, I think. Now, as far as the monitor racks go, I don't get a lot of questions about this, but they're really, really important, okay? A lot of the cheaper monitor racks are basically two big long arms that allow you to mount six monitors on it, okay? So three on each arm. Now, the problem with these arms typically is that they have a very slight bow, okay? So that means that end-to-end, they can be as long as 6 feet. And I personally find it very difficult to use because I don't like to have my monitor spread over 6 feet. You know, I prefer to tilt my left and right monitors in towards the center so I'm surrounded by monitors, okay? So this means that you need to make sure that you get a monitor rack that has elbows, okay? The elbows allow you to point the left and the right monitor in towards you, which is really cool. And I highly, highly recommend this, okay? I originally bought the regular style kind of, you know, racks, and I ended up replacing them with elbow style racks because they make all the difference. All right, guys, that's it. That's my current 7 monitor setup. If you're an existing customer of mine, then there will be an additional section to this video where I go through the exact technical specifications of each one of these components and where you can get them from, okay?